And we're back live at Alterowitz Gym after the Yellowjackets pick up a four-set win over Western Oregon University. Well, we've got Katie Campbell with us, senior for the Jackets today. Katie, your final career volleyball match, what was going through your mind kind of before the matches you prepared for today?
Well, I just kept telling myself I need to cherish these moments because I've been working so hard ever since I was a little kid. And I just wanted to, I was just like, just cherish these moments and just work as hard as you can. And that's it. That's what just went through my mind the whole entire time.
Now, you came to the Yellow Jackets after two seasons at New Mexico Military Institute. Just talk about your time here, getting to spend these last two seasons, and what it's meant to you to be a Jacket.
Oh, it's meant the world to me. It's crazy. Like, Coach Casey saw me whenever I was at New Mexico Military Institute, and she took the chance on me, and I'm very grateful for that. And I'm so, I don't know, I'm just so happy I got to meet everyone, Brave, Sherm, and everybody, the sophomores, freshmen, and Isela. It was great playing with Isela Alvarez again. It was amazing.
That's right, Isela, from your hometown in Dumas, Texas as well. One thing that just stands out about you is how much fun you have down there, how much energy you have. I don't think anybody celebrates harder than you on any given point. Was there something extra going through your mind today when you guys were winning points today in those celebrations?
No, I don't know. Ever since I was, like, in junior high, my coach would always say, just this gives them brings intimidation to other teams, and that's what I went for.
And your final thoughts now, getting to end this season, your career with a win today, what did that mean to you?
It hasn't really hit me yet because I'm not really crying. I'm just, whenever everything, like, settles down and if I'm in my room and thinking about it more, it's going to hit me pretty good.
Been quite the ride over 4 years. One more match today. What's going through your mind right now?
I'm just so thankful to have been a part of this program and thankful for all the girls I've gotten to play with and for the coaching staff and just being here.
And it's been a journey for you, a great freshman year, so much adversity your sophomore year with the injury, and then finishing it off by coming back strong. What do you think kind of defines your career and all you've had to go through?
I think patience, 100%, just having to be patient with myself and not forcing through anything with my knee and just taking it day by day, but yeah. Patience.
And your family getting to come be part of senior day today.
Yeah.
And yeah, as you mentioned, they've been at most all your home games, the ones that you've been playing in. What's it meant to have them here, and what does it mean to have them by your side today?
Oh, it's amazing, because I really didn't know, just from the trip to Colorado to Montana is pretty far, but having them here and having them commute every time is just amazing. It's such a great feeling to have.
Now, talk about this program. You know, the results maybe not there in terms of wins and losses this season, but this is the best season that you guys have had in your career. Why is this program growing, and what makes you so confident about this group that comes back?
I think we're just, I mean, props to Casey with recruiting, but we're just having the right girls, and we're all just meshing so much better, and we're getting girls to stay longer, which is also a good thing. But, yeah, just having that core group that keeps coming back is just really helping us.
And just lastly, comment on what this overall experience, being a Yellow Jacket, coming to MSUB, has meant to you.
Oh, gosh, Evan. it's been amazing. I don't know. I've loved it here ever since I've gotten here, and I've had such a great experience freshman all the way to senior year, and I'm just so thankful for everybody I've met along the way and all the experiences I've had.
That's Yellow Jacket senior Taylor Sherman after completing her career as a Yellow Jacket today at Alterowitz Gym. Taylor, thanks for everything over
Thank
the years.
Thank you. Yeah.
And we are back at Alterowitz Gym now. A victory for the Yellow Jackets in four sets here on senior day over Western Oregon University. Well, Brave, what does it mean to go out with a win? You guys just fought so hard all year long, and to be victorious here today, what does that mean to you?
Yeah, I think just leaving on a positive note, I mean, win or lose, I would have been happy, because ending my career with everyone that was here was just awesome. But I think ending on a win was just kind of the icing on the cake. It was really cool to go out with a win.
And one of the things that stands out about you during your career, just the constant improvement. You've been a four-year starter, but really no dips in the road. You've always gotten better each year, both offensively and defensively, finishing with by far your best year yet. What has this experience been like for you?
It's just been awesome. I think really the coaches and the girls that I've played with have just helped me grow. And coming in my freshman year, those set of girls just made me so much better right away. And I do feel like I have learned a lot here, and I think just the experience really helps me improve. So, I think each year I've just felt better and better, and I'm really happy to end like this.
Now, talk a little bit about Taylor Sherman getting to be a teammate of hers for four straight years and finishing your career with her today.
Yeah, I think, you know, Sherm will always be one of my best friends. I don't want to cry. but I think just the resilience with me and her, just knowing that, you know, we never gave up on the program. We'll never give up on each other. But so, yeah, it's been awesome to have her by my side all 4 years.
Everybody in the gym can hear one distinct voice during the games, even before the games. That's your dad, Tim, yeah. Always encouraging people. It's been like that, not just today, all 4 years.
Yeah.
What did it mean? I saw you looked up at him with the signs he had before the game, and yeah. You could certainly hear him throughout. What was it like having him here one more time?
It was just awesome. I mean, I think I heard him extra loud this time just because one last time they get to do it. it's been awesome to have him here so much, but especially this last one, and my brother and his wife surprised me here, so that was cool too. But just having the whole family together and just having a good time and winning this game with them and having him here with me throughout the whole ride.
Oh, and we talked to Sherm about this too. It's the end of your career, probably hasn't hit you yet that, you know, you're done playing, but this program is building so strong. You get to finish your career with the best performance yet during your career by a team. What does that say about the squad? Why are you so excited about this group moving forward?
Yeah, I think I'm just so excited for them because coming back, if there's no incoming seniors, there's none left. So if they just keep this core group going, I think they really have a lot of talent. They're really good friends off the court, and they really work together on the court. So and I think it shows because we've been improving every single year, just a little bit by little bit. But I think they have a good future ahead of them.
And we'll close out our broadcast today with Yellowjacket head coach Casey Williams at Alterowitz Gym. Well, coach, ending the year on a very positive note, a good solid four set win over Western Oregon today. Talk about the team's performance on an emotional day here.
Yeah, it was a very emotional day. Our three seniors have really been the building blocks of our program as far as I've been here, and done such a great job leadership-wise and just guiding this team towards the team we are today. So very emotional to see them go, and they couldn't have played better to end their careers. Katie Campbell came out and was swinging lights out. Brave was blocking really well, and then Sherm is always consistent over there in the back row. So really cool to see them end on such a high note.
Yeah, and talk about the performance for the team overall. This is a match that, it got even at one set apiece. And this is something you saw against Concordia on Thursday. You won the first set, then they won the next three. What does it mean about this group to not let that happen again and really finish on the front foot?
Yeah, you know, we stumbled a little bit in that second set and didn't play very well. Our passing wasn't very good, and we weren't able to run our middles as much in that second set. And then really took a step back and refocused a little bit and got back into it in the third set and really dominated in that third set. So, I thought we did a really good job playing together as a team and with our energy and our, effort and focus. I thought we did a really good job.
So hard this short after a game to think that the season's over and start looking at next year. But if you look at some of the top performers today, Bailey Monk, who will be a junior next year, and Skylar Reed and Evan Taylor, who will both be sophomores, Skylar offensively and Evan both offensively and defensively today. Just a couple of examples of why you should be excited moving into next season.
Yeah, you know, we'll definitely miss the three seniors, but we also have some really great pieces coming together that will be back next year. Brave will be tough to replace on the block, and then Sherman, KD defensively have been so solid for us this year. So we're definitely going to miss them, but there are some really positive things coming back next year, so excited about that.